Good morning, Ladies Grace, members of the clergies, brothers and sisters, welcome to the communion service, those who are here at home. We start with each word in the big liturgy and simply as one. Bless the Lord, bless the Lord, amen. O my brother, think of thy sins and ask forgiveness, O darkness of devils, before going out of the church. With a pure sacrifice is offered on behalf of thine. Do not separate thyself from the priest who prays and offer the sacrifice on thy behalf, that thou mayest not fall with them baptized whom they sent out, but abide within the church and listen to the word of the priest, and listen to him who asks forgiveness on behalf of me and all sinners, that they all may grant pardon to them. O man, if thou desirest to receive forgiveness of thy sins, why dost thou go from the church when another is born and ask him for mercy on thy behalf? And why art thou idle at that time, let your mind wander from place to place? You are sealed with the seal of the heavenly bridegroom, even Christ, for the church will dismiss thee, and shut the door against thee, so that thou wilt never enter. Because no stranger be found in her, when her bridegroom cometh, she shall open to him her doors, and his bride be the bridegroom. Because it is given to him, who hath seen a bridegroom that at his marriage sacrificed his body and is fed on forever? The Son of God had done the new deed in the world, which no one except for him had done like him since the creation of the world. And his marriage shall ordain on his table before his guests, his holy body and his precious blood as a banquet, so that they that eat thereof, and so that they that believe in him may live forever. The meat and drink is the Lord Jesus Christ at his marriage. Blessed be our God who hath given us his holy body and his precious blood for forgiveness of sin, that we may live thereby forever. Glory be to him, world without end.
Amen.
We start the reading of praise of the Blessed Mother for Sunday. The Book of Praise of the Holy Mary, a hymn of praise for the Sabbath of the Christian day, Sunday. Your name, beloved, O blessed among women, you are the second chamber, for you are called the Holy of Holies, where the tables of the covenant contain the 10 words which was written by the fingers of God. This you have made known to us first by the letter yonder, which are first read of the name of Redeemer Jesus Christ, who became incarnate from you without change, became the mediator of a new covenant. And by the shedding of his blood, he purified the believers and the holy people. Pray to it for us, O Holy One.
Holy Virgin Mary, pray for us.
Lord, magnify you, O Lady, the help of your bearer, for lift up thy spirit, invoke you. Pray for us that we may find grace and mercy with him who is the love of men. You are the tablet of art which are covered up over with gold, which have been made of wood that never would perish, signifying for us the wood of God who became out of all separation and change. Even the holy and undefiled name, who is co-equal the Father, he was announced to us, the pure man without sin, he became like unto us by the might of his wisdom, he who was incarnate from you. Even who is spotless, make his divinity with us, pray to him for us, O Holy One.
O Holy Virgin Mary, pray for us.
You are the sanctuary, the cherubs are wrong as they stand around God. The Word who was incarnate of you, O pure one without change, have become the forgiver of sins and the absolver of our transgressions. Pray to him for us, O Holy One. To give life to all the world, pray to him for us, O Holy One.
O Holy Virgin Mary, pray for us.
God, Christ come, shed light upon us, upon those of us who are sitting in the shadow of darkness of death. And he set our feet upon the path of peace for the mystery of his holy wisdom. Pray to it for us, O Holy One.
O Holy Virgin Mary, pray for us.
God has said so, for because you carry the coals of the blessed fire which he took from the sanctuary, you, as the Word of God, became incarnate of you, and he who offered to his Father himself as incense and precious offerings, pray to him for us, O Holy One.
O Holy Virgin Mary, pray for us.
The garden of delight, the garden of joy, which is planted with the trees of Lebanon, and was prepared for the seal before the world was created, on a great chariot which is guided by cherubim and serpent, like a fashion out of the flames of fire. One of the serpents is now from heaven and sent to the sanctuary. Blessed are thou amongst women, the Holy Spirit shall come upon thee, and the power of the highest will overshadow thee. For he who dwelleth above the cherubim shall become the light of all the world. Rejoice, O Mary, beautiful Dove, who have borne for us the Word of God, and by the sweet scented flower that sprung from the root of Jesse. Pray to him for us, O Holy One.
O Holy Virgin Mary, pray for us.
You are like unto the rod of Aaron, which without being planted in the ground, without watering, bursts into blossom. In like manner, you, O Mary of Christ, did bring forth Christ, O God, in truth, without sin. He came and delivered us. Pray to him for us, O Holy One.
Holy Virgin Mary, pray for us.
It is made for you, O you are full of grace, more than all the saints, to pray on our behalf. You are greater than the high priest, and you are more honorable than the prophets. In you there is majesty of appearance, which is greater than the majesty of the cherubim and the seraphim. Verily you are glory of our race, and you and she must make for life for our souls. Pray now then on our behalf of our Lord and Redeemer Jesus Christ, that he may confirm us in the right faith, that is to say, faith in him, and that may graciously bestow upon us his mercy and compassion. And his abundant mercy to give us our sins forever and ever. Amen. Pray to it for us, O Holy One.
O Holy Virgin Mary, pray for us.
Good morning, brothers and sisters. We are continuing prayer of the Lord.
Thank you. Have mercy upon us, Lord. Glory to the Father. 'tis right, it is just.
O Lord, make our whole invisible glory stretch out our soul to thee, and we offer morning prayer to thee. O Lord, the powerful wisdom of all, God of vengeance and mercy, the maker of the soul, we glorify thee, come from the Father before the creation of the world. Thou art the only one that thus strengthen thy city. At present, by the angels and ceaseless glories, thou wast not created with hands, but art the creator of living things. Thou art the invisible, pure and holy, and the long-suffered told us the wisdom of thy glory. Thou hast made us hope for the unquenchable light, and we thy silver ones offer to thee glory, thanksgiving, and worship, and the people glorify thee.
O God of right, thou art the source of right, the head of knowledge, the giver of grace, of the perfect grace, the maker of the soul, the giver of good, giver of the Holy Spirit, the treasure of wisdom, the helper, the teacher of saints, the foundation of the world, who accepts the prayer of the Holy One. We glorify the only begotten Son, the firstborn word of the Father. Thou hast granted thy universal grace to us who call upon thee. O pure and blameless Father, thou hast a child of good mother, rascal and corrupt, and of which thou givest to those who trust upon thee in all their thoughts. Thou didst make the angel desire to visit the righteous one before the world, and thou art our one change of value. Through thy Father's pleasure thou hast enlightened us. We who are children of darkness, we whom thou hast brought from darkness to light and granted us life after death, and granted us freedom from slavery. With thy cross thou hast brought us now to thy Father in heaven. With the gospel thou hast led us, and with the prophet thou hast comforted us. We whom thou hast brought nigh, O God, give us, O God, life. We praise our God at this ceaseless thanksgiving. We may say that we are thy servants, and the people praise thee.
O Lord, we praise thee.
Thank you.
Amen. Thank you.
Good.
Blessed be Christ, who like the Heavenly Father, with the Holy Spirit, the life giver, for thou hast come and saved us. Yedelem ole abu el women feskidus. Amen. Yedelem ole abu el women feskidus.
Honor thy father and mother, which is commandments with promise, that it may be well with thee, and thou mayest live long on the earth. And ye fathers, provoke not your children to wrath, but bring them up in the nurture and admonition of the Lord. Servants, be obedient to them that are your masters, according to the flesh, with fear and trembling, in singleness of your heart, as unto Christ. Not with eye service as men pleasers, but as the servants of Christ, doing the will of God from the heart, with good will doing service as to the Lord and not to men, knowing that whatsoever good thing any man doeth, the same shall he receive of the Lord, whether he be bond or free. And ye masters, do the same things unto them, forbearing threatening, knowing that your master also is in heaven, neither is there respect of person with him. Amen. The blessing of the Father, the love of the Son, and the gift of the Holy Spirit which came upon the apostles in the upper room of Holy Zion, in like sort come down and be multiplied for me and all of you.
Holy Apostle Paul, good messenger, heal of the sick, come receive the crown, ask and pray fast, that he may save our souls, in the bounty of his mercy and his pity for his holy name's sake.
Their life इनके ऊपर पिता ईश्वर चाहे क्वेश्चन उत्तर दो हमें ओ माय ब्रदर लव फॉर द वर्ल्ड मैटर थिंग कैन डू और वो पत्ते में लव जो फॉलोस करते
Holy consubstantial Trinity, preserve our congregation. For thy holy legs I could seek, comfort us in thy mercy, for thy holy name's sake.
Jesus Christ, O Lord, have mercy.
So Michael was given mercy and glad thanks to Gabriel and the heavenly gift to the Virgin Mary.
Every one of you understanding and gives up to Solomon and all of us to Samuel.
Bengisi antenatina,
Haylem miskanam lezle alemu amin. Eme bita chinkidis dingil mariam roi bemelak bukadus Gabriel salam ta salam inishalem. Asabi singilis visagashim dingilis. Yeshanafi exabeliatoi salam talan chikabashal. Kesiatu shulu telete shant the barakishnish. Yamai simlit felt the barakino sagan it blas. Desia belish, exabir kanchikaranuna, katuvillages, ke gita chin, kevananta chin, Jesus Christus and Yakultan leminelin, hatiata chin in Yasusrelins and Azalealim. Amen. Holy Trinity Pityas, Holy Trinity Spiras, Holy Trinity have mercy.
Rejoice, 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 O Virgin Mary, full of grace.
The Lord is with thee.
Intercede and pray to thy beloved Son,
that he may forgive us our sins.
Gloria be to the Holy Trinity, the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, at all times, both now and ever.
Come on, If then, God so clothed the grass which is today in the field
and tomorrow is not interval of us, how much more will he call you, O ye of little faith? And seek not ye that what ye shall eat, or what ye shall drink, neither be ye of doubtful mind. For all these things do the nations of the world seek after, and your Father knoweth that you have need of all of these things. But rather seek ye the kingdom of God, and all these things shall be added unto you. Fear not, little flock, for it is your Father's good pleasure to give you the kingdom. Resting on verse 32. It is easier for heaven to pass than what little of the Lord to fall.
Page 36 in the Beatitudes, is 82 in a small stanza 210. Glory be to thee, Lord, O God Almighty, who has made us be to hear the word of thy holy gospel, and preaches and rejoicing. Again we ask and beseech that thou shouldest write the word of thy holy gospel in our hearts, and accept our prayers in this thy temple when our Lord Jesus Christ had entered, and send thy mercy and thy compassion upon us and upon thy people, to thy only begotten Son. For thine is the glory and power, world without end.
Amen.
Page 38 in the Vineyard to Jesus, 87 in your small stanza 5.
Yeah.
Slaman Vesuk.
And again we make our supplication to the Almighty God, the Father, of our Lord and our Savior Jesus Christ. We ask and entreat the mightiness, O lover of man. Remember, Lord, our congregation, bless them.
Pray for this holy church and our congregation therein.
Bless our congregation and keep us in peace.
Grant that they may be thine at the counsel of fullness or in their hands, they may do thy holy and blessed will. A house of prayer, a house of purity, and a house of blessing. Give us also, Lord, us thy servants, and to them that shall come after us, vouchsafe us to the end of the world, length of days. Arise, Lord, my God, and let thy enemies be scattered, and let them that hate thy holy and blessed name flee before thee. But let thy people do thy will at all times be blessed with blessings. A thousand, thousand, 10,000 times 10,000. To thy only begotten Son, through whom the thee with him and the Holy Spirit, be glory and dominion, both now and ever, and world without end.
Amen. Let us all say the wisdom of God, the prayer of faith, the Apostles' Creed. We believe in one God, maker of all creation, Father of all Lord, and our God and our Savior, Jesus Christ. Because his nature is unsearchable, as we have before declared, he is without beginning and without end, but he is ever living, and he has life which is never extinguished, and he can never be approached. He is not two or three, and no addition can be made to him, but he is only one, living forever, because he is not hidden that he cannot be known. But we know him perfectly through the law and the prophets, that he is almighty and has authority over all things. One God, Father of all, Lord and our Savior, Jesus Christ, who was begotten before the creation of the world, the only begotten Son, who is one with him,
creator of all those, the
principalities and dominions, who in the last days was pleased to become man, and took flesh from all Lady Mary, the Holy Virgin, without the seed of man, and grew like men, yet without sin or evil. May neither was thy found in his mouth.
The rest of us died in the flesh, rose from the dead on the third day,
ascended into heaven to the Father who sent him, sat down at the right hand of power, sent to us the Paraclete, the Holy Spirit, who proceeded from the Father,
and saved all the world, and who is going to another the Father and the Son. We say to them that all creatures are born of heaven, and there is nothing to be rejected, and the Spirit, the life of our body, is pure and pure and pure. We say that marriage is pure, and that birth is undefiled, because God created Adam and Eve to multiply. We understand fully that there is no bodily soul, which is immortal and does not perish with the body. We repeat all the rules of heritage that was preserved and commanded of the Lord, because he has for us in pure. We also believe in the resurrection of the dead, the righteous and sinners, and in the day of judgment, when everyone will be recompensed according to his deeds. We also believe that Christ is not in the least degree inferior because of his incarnation, but he is God, the Word who truly became man, and reconciled mankind to God, being the high priest of the Father. Henceforth, let us not be circumcised like the Jews. We know that he who had to fulfill the law and the prophets has already come. To him for whose coming all people look forward, Jesus Christ, who is descended from Judah, from the root of Jesse, whose government is upon his shoulder. To him be glory, thanksgiving, greatness, blessing, praise, both now and ever, and world without end.
Amen. Page 41 in the Bible to Jesus, 94 in a small stanza, 46.
He that is pure, let him deceive of the omniscient, and he that is not pure, let him not deceive of the omniscient. bringing upon himself a curse instead of a blessing, and will get from forth the fire of hell instead of the remission of sin.
Oh, my Lord, my God, Lord of the Lord, ever peace and love, take away from me every evil thought, revenge, envy, and all the lust of the flesh. Make me meet to be added to thy holy servants, so who please thee by the beauty of your life, in the days of love and peace. Because it is thou that is come down from heaven, and make peace between the inhabitants of heaven and the inhabitants of earth, and there is gathered together all thy people to glorify thee, for thine is the glory, world without end.
Jesus Christus said, you're done again, not yet.
again, O poor of Mary, not at length but briefly. And I speak the praise of the Virgin, not in many words which would be forgotten, but in few. And I speak of the exaltation of the Virgin. And today I stand this very day in humility and love before this mighty mystery, and before this table and offering. Truly, this is the offering which those who spiritually fire cannot taste. It is not like the sacrifice of the forefathers which depended upon the blood of sheep and oxen and cows, but it is fire. It is a fire, give up life to the upright in heart to fulfill his will. It is a consuming fire to the unrighteous to deny his name. Truly it is a fire which a fire of cherubim and seraphim who are flame of fire cannot touch. O Mary, for this we love and exalt thee, because thou didst bear for us the true food of righteousness and the true drink of life. O our fathers, consecrated by the laying on of hands, who are the successors of the apostles, we have taken you for intercessor towards God, and we have taken for intercessors between us and God during our days these two, the Patriarch of Ethiopia, Amacorius and Amatias, and the Blessed Archbishop Amatias.
Sit down.
Holy Trinity, Father, Son, Holy Spirit, bless thy people, Christian. Beloved, bless the heavenly earth. And descend upon us, the grateful Holy Spirit, and the great Lord, thy holy church, open up for us. The mercy of the faith and perfect of us, the grateful thy holy Trinity, and Father, the earth. O my Lord Jesus Christ, who is the seed of thy people, hail them and guide our fathers and our brothers and our sisters who have gone forward to become stranger. Bring them back to the dwelling place in peace and in heaven. Bless them, O heaven, and learn the truth of them of this year. And I pour down in thy gifts and make joy and gladness prevent the perpetual drift of the earth. And establish well thy feast and heart of fighting to be kindly of the way. Grant the peace to stir all the chain while the chinwari gathers thy holy chain to all the infidels in the land. In the presence of all the king of that peace, rest the soul of our fathers and our brothers and our sisters who are born and sleep and gather in the brightness of the power of our hands. Look us again, our majesty, yourself, and our brothers and our mother, and let him carry on our sisters to Pitamba, and all other brothers and sisters who are born and sleep. And bless those giving of incense and bread and wine, ointment and oil and honey, and beautiful services of sanctuary. That Christ our God, making them very well, the heavenly Jerusalem and all that are subject to God, great for mercy. Christ our God, have mercy upon them and all them that give unto to thy word and sacrifice of mercy. And comfort the restricted souls of that are chained and that are in their own captivity. And them that are held in the heavens, them to you, thou God, give them thy mercy. And all them that are interested to our sins and to them our supplication to thee. O our Master Jesus Christ, remember them thy heavenly kingdom. And remember me thy sinful servant. O Lord, send thy people and bless thy miracles. Feed them and give them up for you.
Lord, beating our bishop on the patriarchs, archbishops, bishops, priests and deacons, and all of the shut people,
And over to then page 75 in the Bhagavad Gita, stanza 18.
Om Etasiga, Etasiga Daisa, Purasiga Vichamo, the rest of the souls of the world of Pesha, Ashvashas, Vishas, Krishadipa, who keep straight the way of the true world, kings, rulers, princes, those in authority, young men, virgin, monks, rich, poor, great, small, old women, orphans, sojourners, miserables, and all Christian people, from the congregation of the church when days go by are born to their rest, make goodness intercession for those who are fallen asleep in this place, that he thyself may give their souls a quiet rest. In every place which is called the place of the victorious martyrs, in the place of the blessed righteous, in the place of the watchful angels, thou art the emeritus in every place, and thy name is acceptable before God.
He that are sitting, stand up.
Let us stand up in the fear of God to exalt and glorify the Lord who is full of glory, saying, O thou who art full of grace, O thou who art the channel of joy, thou hast a more beautiful countenance than the cherubim of many eyes and the seraphim of six wings.
Look to the east.
Truly, God the Father, look up from heaven towards the east, the west, the north, and the south, and towards all the ends of the earth. He breathed in every safe heart, called not like unto thee. He approved thy safe heart, loved thy duty, and so said to thee, his son, we love him. Holy is God the Father, who loved thee. Holy is the only begotten Son, who abode in thy womb. And holy is the Paraclete, the Spirit of righteousness, who strengthened thee.
Answer,
holy, 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 perfect Lord of hosts, heaven and earth are full of the holiness of thy glory.
O Virgin, full of glory, with whom and what likeness shall we lighten thee? Thou art the Lord from which Emmanuel took his ineffable garment of flesh. He made the world from the same flesh as that of Adam, and the womb is thy flesh. The shuttle is the Word himself, Jesus Christ. The length of the warp is the shadow of God the Most High. The weaver is the Holy Spirit. How marvelous and wonderful is this thing! O bridge over which the ancient fathers crossed from death unto life. O ladder from earth to heaven, through thee the first creation was renewed. Thou wast the womb of Adam, and he was driven out from paradise. The meekness of Abel, who was killed through unrighteousness, the kindness of Seth, the works of Enoch, the ark of Noah, through which he was saved from the evil destruction, the blessing and portion of Shem, the sojourning of Abraham, the savior of Isaac, the ladder of Jacob, the comforter of Joseph, the tables of Moses, the bush of Sinai, the bells and the garment of Aaron the priest, the rod which grew, blossomed and bore fruit, the stone of testimony of Joshua, the fleece of Gideon, the bottle of ointment and horn of oil of Samuel, the root of Jesse of which he boasted, the chariots of Abedin, the half of David, the crown of Solomon, the garden closed, the spring shut up, the golden womb of Elijah, the bruise of Elisha, the virgin conception of which Isaiah prophesied, the first giving birth without intercourse of which Daniel also spoke, the mountain of Paran and Habakkuk, the closed house in the east of Ezekiel, the place in Bethlehem from which the Lord goes forth, the land of Ephrathah of Micah, the tree of life of Solomon, the healer of Nahum's womb, the rejoicing of Zechariah, the clean wall of Malachi. O Virgin, thou art the ideal and the prophecy of the prophet, the favor of the apostles, the father of martyrs, the sister of the angels, the ghost of the young men, and the virgins, and the monks, who are watchful day and night against thee. the Lord provides us the word from our many languages. O Virgin, thou didst not grow in birth like the Hebrew daughters who skip on their hands, but thou didst live in a sanctuary in holiness and purity. O Virgin, thou didst not eat earthly bread, but heavenly bread prepared in the heaven of heaven. O Virgin, thou didst not drink earthly drink, but heavenly drink poured from the heaven of heaven. O Virgin, thou didst not know uncleanness and the woman that were before thee, and had to come after thee, but thou art adorned with holiness and purity. O Virgin, the wicked young man could not entice thee, but the angels of heaven visited thee, and as it was said, the priests and the high priests praised thee. O Virgin, thou wast not espoused to Joseph for coming together, but in order that he might keep thee in purity, and thus it was fulfilled. Wherefore the Father saw thy purity, he said to thee, his effulgent angel whose name is Gabriel, and he said unto thee, the Holy Spirit shall come upon thee, and the power of the Highest shall overshadow thee. The Word came to thee without being separated from the bosom of its Father. Thou didst conceive him without his being limited, and he stayed in thy womb without making subtraction from above or addition beneath. Therefore, in thy womb, inestimable and unsearchable fire of the morning, it is not just to compare him with earthly fire. Fire has measurement and volume, but of the deity it cannot be said that it is like this, or even seems to be like this. The Godhead have no circle like the sun and moon, no stature like man, but he is mighty and sitting in the highest heaven, which neither the thought of man nor the knowledge of angels can reach. The deity hath neither breadth nor length, hath neither above nor beneath, neither left nor right, but he always filleth all things. The deity hath openings wherein to stretch or contract itself, but he fills every place. The deity hath neither firmament above nor foundation beneath, but he himself is the firmament and the foundation. The deity does not stoop about on the head to take up that which is on earth, but all is in his hand, as he showed to Peter. The deity hath neither chest nor back by which he can be seen, and through which he can be limited, but he is covered with a flame of fire, and he himself is a flame of fire. The deity is clean, pure, and bright. We believe that the Father who sends his Father in his nature. We believe that the Son who has sent his Son in his nature. We believe that the life-giving Holy Spirit is Holy Spirit in his nature. Three names, but one more. It is not with the deity as it was with Abraham, who was older than Isaac, or with Isaac, who was older than Jacob. But the Father is not older than the Son, neither is the Son older than the Holy Spirit, and the Holy Spirit is not younger than the Father the Son, neither is the Son younger than his Father. It is not with the deity as it was with Abraham, who gave commands to Isaac, or with Isaac, who gave orders to Jacob. But the Father, being Father, does not give orders to the Son, and the Son, being Son, is not exalted. And the Holy Spirit is equal, but the Divine Father, Son, and Holy Spirit are one Lord, one kingdom, one authority, and one government. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit think, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit speak, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit mind, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit take counsel, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit utter the word. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come to me. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit me. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit unite. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit create one. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit send. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit give authority. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit bear witness. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit show. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit are custom. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit advise. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit unify. The Father, Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, Amen. The Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, Hallelujah. The Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, strengthen. The Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, encourage. The Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, teach. The Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, crown. The Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, clothe. The Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, grant grace. The Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, sin. The Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, judge. The Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, examine. Thus we, without separated or divided, believe and confess the oneness and unity, so that it will not be divided or separated. Let us distinguish, so that it will not be confused. We do not say three as we say Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, but one is three persons. We do not say one like Adam, the first creature, but three with one nature. Now we hear the Jews and the ignorant Ishmaelites, who being without understanding, say, God is one person and one body. They have a blind heart. Now we see that idolatrous heathen, whose idols are many and whose devils are many. But we call the leaders to the good way, as the apostles taught us, say, the Father is the Son is the Son, and the Holy Spirit is the Son. But it is one Son of righteousness over all. The Father is fire, the Son is fire, the Holy Spirit is fire. But it is one fire of life in the highest heaven. The Father is the dawn, the Son is the dawn, and the Holy Spirit is the dawn. But it is one eastern dawn, through which, by the rays of its light, the darkness was destroyed. The Father is the vine, the Son is the vine, and the Holy Spirit is the vine. But it is one vine of life from which all the world tasted. The Father is milk, the Son is milk, and the Holy Spirit is milk. But it is one milk on me. Thus we believe, and thus we confess, and say the creed.
We believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and all things visible and invisible. And we believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of the Father, was it came before the creation of the world, light from light, true God from true God, begot not made of one essence of the Father, by whom all things were made, and without him was not anything in heaven or earth made, who was meant for salvation, came down from heaven, was made man, was incarnate from the Holy Spirit, and from the Holy Virgin Mary, became man, was crucified for sakes in the days of Pontius Pilate, suffered, died, was buried, rose from the dead on the third day, as was written in the Holy Scriptures, ascended in glory to heaven, sat at the right hand of his Father, will come again in glory. There is no end of his reign, and we believe in the Holy Spirit, the life-giving God, who proceeded from the Father, worship and glorify him with the Father and the Son, who spoke by the prophets. And we believe in the one holy universal apostolic church. And we believe in one baptism for the remission of sins. And we wait for the resurrection from the dead, and life to come, world without end.
Amen. Let us now return again to speak of the Holy Virgin, speaking of the conception which is wonderful to all, and say, O Virgin, when they are holy, I hold the fire of the Godhead, whose face is fire, whose clothes are fire, whose covering is fire, how did it not burn thee? In what part of thy womb is heaven blazing of the flame of fire prepared and spread? Would it in the right or the left side, where thou wast a small body? In what part of thy womb was the glittering, cherubic throne, compassed by the flame of fire, prepared and planted, while thou wast the young bride? How wonderful it is, immortal and amazing, the narrowness of the womb and the infinite conception without intercourse, as a we conceive from the voice of a word, milk with virginity. When I think of this, my mind likes to swim in the depth of thy sun sea, and the billows from the hiding place of the beloved sweep across it. Again, when I think of this, my mind likes to soar and ascend secretly, and draw back the curtains of the hiding places praises of the living one. It becomes a prey of the flame of fire, does not reach one, even one fourth of the way to heaven. When I think of this, my mind likes to mount the shoulders of the wind, to fly east, west, north and south to all the ends of the world, to see the beauty of the creature, to measure the depths of the sea, and to know the height of heaven, and traveling thus to every part, it becomes faith and returns again to its former place. Now let us not further inquire, even think of the greatness and profundity of it, whose grandeur cannot worthily be praised. Know not by the tongues of the prophets or of the apostles. He is the mighty one who not manifested by subtle device, but he became humble among us. He is the most high to whom none can attain, but above us he took upon him the form of a servant. He is the impalpable fire, but we saw him and felt him and ate and drank with him. Now let us praise him, saying, Holy,
Holy Mighty, Holy Living Immortal, one born from the Holy Virgin Mary, have mercy upon us all. Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Living Immortal, who abides in God, who is high and true of cross, have mercy upon us, Lord. Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Living Immortal, who lives right from the end of the day, ascended to heaven in glory, stand at the right hand of his Father, and will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead. Have mercy upon us, Lord. Glory to the Father, glory to the Son, glory to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and in the world of them. Amen and amen. So be it, so be it. Holy Trinity, living God, have mercy upon us.
O Virgin, who give the fruit that can be eaten, and the spring of life that can be drunk, O bread, cut from thee, that giveth life and salvation to those who eat of it in faith. O bread, cut from thee, that is as hard as the soul of Adam, which cannot be chewed, to those who do not eat of it in faith. O cup, cut from thee, that helpeth those who drink of it in faith to ignite wisdom, and that giveth them life. O God, cut from thee that intoxicate them those who do not drink of it in faith, and cause them to stumble and fall, and add in sin to them instead of the remission of sin. And now let us glorify and say, Glory be to thee, glory to thy kingdom, glory with your incense we offer to thee.
Remember us, Lord, in thy kingdom. Remember us, Lord, Master, in thy kingdom. Remember us, Lord, in thy kingdom, and thou remember the thief on the right hand, and thou wast on the tree of the holy cross.
Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, from whom is formed every good gift and every perfect gift, became man, fulfilled all the law of man, yet without sin, and lived among the Hebrews. He was baptized by John, tempted in the wilderness, hungered and thirsted, and did miracles. In the same night in which he gave his soul to death, he showed his disciples many signs concerning his suffering, crucifixion, death, his resurrection on the third day with body and soul, with bone and blood, as it was before when his disciples were with him, on his right and his left. And when there was counted with them, Judas, whose creation was like the tares, added to the wind, who also betrayed him.
Priest, raise up your hand.
At that time, Jesus Christ took bread in his holy, blessed, pure, and spotless hand.
We believe that this is he, truly believe.
He looked up to heaven, towards his Father, interceded in his fair wrath, and committed his disciples to him, to keep them from all evil. Bless while he was blessed, broke while it was holy, and gave it to his disciples and said unto them, Take, eat, this bread is my body which will be given to you as propitiation for all the world.
Amen, amen, amen.
believe and confess. Glorify thee, O Lord and O God, and this is he we truly believe.
And likewise also the cup, after supper, he pointed and said, take, drink, this cup is my blood, which is spilled and shed for your sake.
Amen, amen, amen. We believe and confess. We glorify thee, O Lord and O God, and this is he we truly believe.
And as often as you do this, death, I proclaim the remembrance of my resurrection.
We believe in my death, Lord, and my holy resurrection. We believe in my ascension and my second advent. We glorify thee and confess thee. We offer our prayers unto thee and complete thee. O Lord, Lord, and all.
O our Lord, as it happened then, bless, bring, and give this bread.
Amen.
O Lord, as it happened then, bless how. This my ministry, purify and choose it, and let it please thee.
Amen.
And this grace who is with me to help me in this ministry, and me make like Joseph and Nicodemus, who wrap thy body.
Amen.
And this deacon sent according to the law of ministry, suffer to reach all great ground of priesthood. I make him full of grace, righteousness, and favor, esteem unto soul in Trinity and marvel. I was astonished to the descent of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
And these people who are gathered together in thy holy church with priests and deacons, great and small, make worthy to take thy holy ministry. Have compassion and do not judge them.
Amen. Lord, pity upon us. Lord, spare us. Lord, have mercy upon us.
Lord, have mercy upon us, O Christ.
Lord, have mercy
upon us, O
Christ.
Lord, have mercy upon us, O Christ.
Lord, have mercy upon us, O Christ. With all the heart, let us beseech the Lord our God that he grant unto us the good communion of the Holy Spirit. And the Lord is in the hand of generation of generation, world without end.
Grant us to be united to thy Holy Spirit, that heal us by the salvation. That we may live in thee forever.
Grant us to be united to thy Holy Spirit,
and give us by this oblation, that we may live in thee forever. Blessed be the name of the Lord, and blessed be that cometh in the name of the Lord. And let the name of his glory be blessed, so be it.
Blessed be the name of the Lord, and blessed be he that cometh in the name of the Lord.
And let the name of his glory be blessed, so be it, so be it, so be it then. Send the grace of the Holy Spirit upon us.
Send the grace of the Holy Spirit upon us.
Best.
one has a
Thank you.
the Holy Spirit.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Exio Marana Christo. Through whom the Holy Spirit be glory.
Ixio Tessalina
Salam
Mislam and Vesica.
This is the true Holy Body of our Lord and our God and our Savior Jesus Christ, which is given for life of salvation and for remission of sin. Unto them that receive of it in faith.
Amen.
This is the true precious blood of our Lord and our God and our Savior Jesus Christ, which is given for life of salvation and for remission of sin. Unto those who drink of it in faith.
Amen.
For this is the body and blood of Emmanuel, our very God.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. I believe, and I confess unto my latest breath that this is the body and blood of our Lord and our God and our Savior Jesus Christ, which he took from the lady of our soul, the Holy Mary of Tumor Virginity, and made it one with his forehead without mix or confusion, without division or alteration. And he verily confessed with a good testimony in the days of Pontius Pilate, and this body he gave up for sins and for the life of our soul. That this is his body was not separated from his father, not for an hour, nor for the twinkling of an eye, but he gave it up for sins, for life and for salvation, and for remission of sin, unto them that partake of it in faith.
Amen.
That this is the body and blood of our Lord and our God and our Savior Jesus Christ, and that to him I write with you honor, glory, and adoration of his kind Heavenly Father and the Holy Spirit, the Light Giver, both now and ever, and world without end.
Amen.
Everyone stands as one then, O my Lord.
O my Lord Jesus Christ, is no wise beseemeth thee to come under the roof of my polluted house, but provoke thee to wrath, and have done evil in thy sight, and through the transgression of thy commandment have polluted my soul and my body, which thou didst create after thy image and thy likeness, and in me dwelleth no good thing. But for the sake of thy contrivance and thy incarnation for my salvation, for the sake of thy precious cross and thy life-giving death, for the sake of thy resurrection on the third day, I pray thee and beseech you, O my Lord, that thou wouldest purge me from all guilt and curse, and from all sin and defilement. And when I have received thy holy mystery, let it not be unto me for judgment, nor for condemnation, but have compassion upon me, and have mercy upon me, and through it grant me remission of my sin, and life for my soul, O life of the world, through the petition of Our Lady, the Holy Mary of twofold virginity, thy mother, and of John the Baptist, and through the prayer of all the holy angels, and all the martyrs and the righteous, who have fought for the good world without end. Amen.
Thank you.
of this holy day, we pray and trust that as if we are received, may be meaning for the life of the soul, I be glorified the Lord, O Lord.
I will exalt thee, my King and my God, I will bless thy name forever and ever.
Thank you.
morning, the Holy Spirit is coming. We have a service from the Father, Brother, from the earth, and our Father, and we can reach at court. We will have a good prayer, and we can pray that and do it. We will have a good food, we will have a good strength, and we will have a good prayer. We will have a good sleep. We will have a good prayer, and we will have a good prayer. This morning,
this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us and rescue us from all evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Our Lady Mary, the
creation of the Archangel Gabriel, our living right thought and body, even of the Almighty God, salutation is due to thee. Blessed art thou among men, and blessed the fruit of thy womb. Hail, Lord, and I, the favor of the Lord is with thee. Pray for mercy to thy beloved Son, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
O God,
I am a son
of God, for you are the God of the Lord, and I am the God of the Lord. Oh, my God.
Christ, may we sit him down. Ricardi Bessimai, Dio Nicini, Umbem Deltium, Galetin Tracens of Nazaria, Bellacini, Cabore, Inihaia, Bellinit, Mingela, Beto, Fatamatakwan, Bukit Frua, Delinci, Mengisi, Antilatina, Ayamis, Kanam, Jesus Christus zem, Kapitan de Mendelin, Hatia Dachinin, Yatsis.
Good morning, your grace. Holy fathers, brothers and sisters. This morning we'd like to invite our priest in charge of Menania M. Maruka, their society's last union, to bring the symbol this morning. Stand in his presence and offer praise and supplication unto his holy and blessed name, which was made possible through his incarnation of the Blessed Mother, his death, resurrection, for our sake. Yes, brothers and sisters, it is important for us to understand the message that our Lord and our God and our Savior Jesus Christ came and delivered to us through his holy gospel by the apostles. We have the first lesson was taken from Ephesians chapter 6. Ephesians chapter 6 from verse 1 to 9. A very important lesson to us because obedience is one of the most important applications we need as Christians to receive the promise that our Lord has given us. This is why the first lesson in Ephesians starts with the children, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right. Honor thy father and mother, which is the first commandment of the promise, that it may be well with thee, and thou mayest live long on the earth. Why our Lord mentioned this? St. Peter mentioned this in the epistle. He said, children, obey your parents in the Lord. We see charity begins at home and ends abroad. If we do not have this discipline, this respect, and this love to obey our parents, it is impossible for us to come in the church to obey those in authority over us. And we cannot say that we love the Lord and is doing his will, and we are not obeying those who is in authority over us. For our Lord set all these things in the church for obedience and for his will. We see the children of Israel, the walls of Jericho came down because they obeyed what the Lord told them to do. Not by any might of their own, but just through obedience, the walls of Jericho came crumbling down. And we see also in the church, we have sacraments, we have orders, for us also to obey, that we may receive this blessing and the salvation of our souls. For if we sin and we fall short, we must come to confession. This is obedience. Our Lord said to be tired. This also is obedience. You see, the Lord do not need our money. He is all-powerful, almighty, and all-knowing. But for the body, which he is the head of, for us to be able to be functioning properly and in order, we must obey so everyone can play their part and will be able to overcome all the snares and the traps of the enemy. We see also in the second lesson, which was taken from Revelation chapter 12, Revelation chapter 12, from verse 1 to 12. We read from verse 9. And the great dragon was cast out, that old serpent called the devil and Satan, which deceived the whole world. He was cast out into the earth, and his angels were cast out with him. And I heard a loud voice saying in heaven, now is come salvation and strength and the kingdom of our God and the power of his Christ, for the accuser of the brethren is cast down, which accuseth them before our God day and night. Yes, brothers and sisters, through this holy church, we understand that we have this salvation, this power to overcome, this powerful accuser, not by our own strength, but through the strength and power of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. All we have to do is to obey the teachings of the church, and we'll be able to resist the devil, as the scripture said, if we want the devil to flee from us, resist him and he will flee. But we must apply the teachings of the church and the Holy Scriptures to our life, for the power of Christ to do what is impossible for us to do. For he has already overcome death and sin for our sake, so that we may have salvation. Obedience is important because after we leave this place, we read in the Holy Gospel of St. Luke, the man had a vineyard, and year after year, he had filled his little bit of barn. And one year, he had plenty of it. And what he did? He break down the smaller barns and the bigger ones to store for himself. This is a reminder of us, brothers and sisters. All that we work for, all that we have, is from God and is for God by service to our brothers and sisters in the body of Christ. This is all we'll be able to present to our Lord, not these big barns full of fruits. We see the Bible said Thou fool, this night a soul is required of thee. And who did he leave those things for? He did not take them to present them to the Lord and say, I have gone this way. Let us be mindful of who we are, to help us to be obedient and to constantly remind us of who we are as a people. The psalmist made it very clear that we are dust. And if we are dust, brothers and sisters, how can we want to exalt ourselves one against another? Nothing that we have is our own. And if we cannot simply obey the words of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, how can we come and want to do great and marvelous things? Let us understand our part and our role in the body of Christ. We see that there was a war in heaven, and the devil and his angels, because they disobeyed and wanted to make themselves rulers over Almighty God, they were cast out. They were cast out because of their disobedience and pride. Let us examine ourselves and see if any of these ways are within us that will hinder us from receiving this salvation. Don't care how much we are exalted among men. If we do not please God, our life are in vain. And this rich man, this man who had the bands and broke them down, he might have had a high stature amongst men if he had lived. But when he died, he had nothing to present to the Lord but his own deceitful words, his greed, and his pride. And this will not help us to enter into the kingdom. All that we have, let us use it, as the Bible says, for the edifying of the church, for the body of Christ, so that we may be able to overcome, through the grace of God, these trials and tribulations that look as though they are heavy and great to us, but in the sight of Almighty God, it is nothing for us, for Him to take away from us. Let us continue to remember also the privilege that has been granted unto us to be able to be in the kingdom of God in His holy church while we are here in the flesh on earth. Let us take every opportunity and every privilege to work in obedience and love and compassion towards one another, so that we, our light may shine in the world in this time of darkness, and we be able to be the soul of the earth, the soul to our own brothers and sisters out there. As we see also in the scriptures, the masters, even having master over them, it's not that we have lordship over the people, but our responsibility to our family, first to our God, to our nation, and our community, to proclaim this wonderful word of God, this gospel, which is freedom from darkness into light. Let us continue to walk in the light and flee the works of darkness. Glory to God forever and ever. Amen.
Jesus Christ, grant us thy peace and confirm unto us thy peace, and forgive us our sins and make us worthy to go out and to come into our homes in peace. Amen. May he bless the hand of his servant, the Archbishop.
O Lord, send thy people.
For grace, we have received it.
glorify thee.
Amen.